Well, we practiced at the Rose Bowl, and there were, I think there were a couple of days that we had to call practice off because of the smog. I mean, guys' eyes were watering and what have you, and we were staying up in at a retreat area, which was, you know, plenty far away from any of the LA stuff. So it was, and a couple tempers were getting on edge because practicing at the field there at the Rose Bowl, we would have to just take a short bus ride back to the stadium. And, you know, some guys are lingering around after practice and the bus is waiting for them, and some guys are on the bus and they want to get back and get showered and get out, go out, see the sights, whatever. So there was a lot of little friction going on there. So it was all coming to a head for the game at the right time. Well, back then, the Big Ten was, you know, fat and slow, you know, style football and what have you. And supposedly the Pac-10 was, you know, faster and blah, blah, blah. So when we played them, I mean, they were quick. I mean, I thought, Pete told me, he said, listen, if we are going to kick off, I want you to very first play, get a call and just yell it out and have everybody take a hit at the guy across from them. I says, yeah, that'll be great, you know. So we go out there. They were so fast that by the time I was called it out, we were like perfect timing with the snap, and we got a sack. You know, I mean, it was like unbelievable timing is what it was, because I didn't realize they were really fast coming up in the line and everything. And so that was it. That set the tone. And then after the game, of course, it had to be a sub. He said, yeah, let's run around, do a lap, show them how out fat and out of shape we are. And I said, yeah, go ahead. You guys go do it. we're not going to do it because, you know, the weather changed. It was hot and it was tough game. And they were a pretty good team.